Mr. Gibson. It's Gibson, and it's a beautiful ES-125. I'm told this guitar is from 1965, and it's in quite beautiful shape for a guitar of that age. The owner is unhappy with the playability and is convinced that we need more relief. The truss rod really isn't doing anything. All it's doing is sort of sitting there loose. So I'm going to measure the relief and look at a couple other options here. Clamping the neck is not going to be an option on this guitar, mainly because of the fact that I tried it already and I got no results. So adding extra relief to the neck that way isn't going to work. But let's just check it out and see what we actually have. Got the old capo there. Got my feeler gauge. And there's actually greater than 12 thou relief there. That's well within spec. In fact, it could be a little less depending on who you are. So, I'm not quite sure where to head with this. I can make a suggestion, but let me just think about it for a minute. And I'll make that suggestion. So the strings we have on it right now are 12s. 12 to, I believe, 52. What you could do is go to 13s, and you could also go to flat wound strings, which creates a lot more tension because there's more surface area of the string. I'll let all the physics geniuses in the crowd out there noodle that one for a while, why a flat wound string has more tension than a round wound string because there's more surface area. So with that in mind, all I can do is check everything else that I can check. I'm going to put the fret rocker on every fret and see what's going on. That's all I can do. Why have I got that tune stuck in my head? Don't you want me, baby? I'm thinking that's what the owner of the guitar would be singing. Don't you want me, baby? I can't find anything wrong with this guitar. I'm serious. I think what's wrong with it is my feeble playing. All right, with all that being said, all I can do is recommend putting heavier strings on it and going to a flat wound string, which will create more tension on the neck. The neck is beautifully straight, just straight enough, not too curved, but yet curved enough as far as the measuring devices point out. So here we are once again, folks. We could call this a gooch, but it's too beautiful a guitar, so it's sort of just, I don't know what to call it. It's sort of one of those anomalies of life, I guess. Guitars really own us. We don't own them. This is what I've learned over the years. Cheers, folks.